So what happens if you get laser eye surgery while having large pupils? Oh, you almost certainly will develop issues like these. Not fun, right? In today's video, I will explain why you will almost certainly develop these vision issues after having laser eye surgery. My name is James, and I've been living with laser eye surgery complications for close to 6 years now, and I also have large pupils. So what makes you qualified to speak on this besides having lived with these issues for so long? Well, I've done a lot of my own research as to why large pupils cause these vision issues, as well as ways I could try to mitigate some of the vision issues caused by having large pupils. I try things like using medicated eye drops for glaucoma patients, wearing custom design scleral contact lenses, and also driving my car at night with the overhead lamp on, among other things. Needless to say, none of these have been very helpful. The glaucoma drops are only temporary, and they work by constricting the pupil, but the problem is, when the pupil is constricted, it ends up making my night blindness worse, since the constricted pupil cannot take in as much light as a dilated pupil. Scleral lenses do slightly minimize the halos and starbursts I get around with lights at night, but unfortunately, they can make other issues worse, such as my daytime glare, which is why I haven't really been wearing them much lately. Obviously, driving with the overhead light on, it is not really practical and potentially illegal, and the glare I get from the overhead lamp just creates its own issues, so it's not really worth the benefits that I receive from it constricting my pupils. So really the best thing to do is just not get laser eye surgery if you have large pupils. You know what? Even better, just don't get it at all, regardless of what your pupil size is. So you're probably wondering, how do I know if I actually have large pupils? Well, pupil size should be measured in the dark, where the pupil is dilated, meaning it's at its largest size. The diameter of the pupil, which is the length from one side of the pupil to the other, needs to be measured, and this measurement is usually always in millimeters. So your pupil size is considered large, not so much in absolute terms, but basically in relative terms to the type of surgery you're having, and more specifically, how large the ablation zone is going to be. So the ablation zone is the area in which corneal tissue is removed. Generally, the more nearsighted you are, or more myopic you are, the steeper your cornea is going to be, and therefore the more corneal tissue is going to need to be removed in order to flatten it to a sufficient degree. If you're very nearsighted and also have thinner corneas, then you almost always won't be a candidate for LASIK, because LASIK requires more corneal tissue than other types of refractive eye surgeries, because they need that extra tissue in order to create a flap. So I actually wasn't a candidate for LASIK, but I had something called PRK, because it doesn't require as much corneal tissue, because instead of creating a flap, they're just completely removing that tissue. And needless to say, I was very nearsighted and had thinner corneas, so LASIK was definitely not an option for me. So at this point, you're probably wondering, James, you could talk about having large pupils, but why does that matter? Like, what kind of issues can you develop from having large pupils, and why do they actually occur? So the most common issues you're going to run into with having large pupils will be seeing halos and starbursts at night around light sources. And the reason for this is that with in the dark, your pupils are going to dilate, meaning, again, they're going to get larger. And when they dilate past a diameter that is larger than the ablation zone, that's going to create issues, because that area of the cornea between past the ablation zone and in between the dark adapted pupil is untreated. And the way the light gets refracted in that untreated area is what causes these halos and starbursts to occur. I'm not going to get into really the science behind why that occurs, because that's actually a specific topic I'd want to cover more in a future video. But just know for now that, generally speaking, the higher the discrepancy between your dark adapted pupil diameter and the diameter of the ablation zone, the more likely you're going to have these nighttime vision issues, and they're probably going to be at a greater severity than if your pupil size and the ablation zone are closer, or ideally your dark adapted pupil size is a smaller diameter than the ablation zone. When you get your laser eye surgery consultation, make sure somebody measures your pupil size in a dark environment so you can get that dark adapted pupil size, which is basically the largest your pupil is going to get. And then make sure you know exactly how large the ablation zone is going to be for the proposed surgery that they want to potentially perform on you. Again, a large pupil is really only considered large in relation to the perspective ablation zone. However, if I were to put in absolute terms what a large pupil is, I would say anything over 7 millimeters tends to be pretty large. And just for reference, my pupils get to grow to a size of over 8 millimeters in the dark. This should be something that your surgeon tells you beforehand. And if they don't discuss pupil size or the size of the ablation zone or anything prior to getting the surgery, run. And if you're in a consultation with an ophthalmologist, talk about laser eye surgery. Also, run. So I hope you guys found this video helpful. Again, I do not condone that anybody, no matter what pupil size they have, ever get refractive eye surgery. However, if you must, for some reason, get it, then make sure you're aware of these things and you educate yourself beforehand, because pupil size does matter. No matter what these surgeons tell you these days, and a lot of them will say pupil size doesn't matter, and that is complete nonsense. It absolutely matters 100%. So if you're thinking about getting surgery, make sure that the planned ablation zone is larger than the diameter of your dilated pupils. Until next time, stay strong, warriors.